welcome back. Now we're ready to start laying down our color. I'm going to start off the front panel, since it's mostly plastic and nice and smooth now, with some adhesion promoter. You can get this at any auto parts store, and usually the best thing to do is use the same brand of the paint that you're actually going to use also. All I do is lay down a very, very light coat of some of this adhesion promoter on top of the plastic that's been sanded smooth. Now I'm coming in with some self-etching primer. I'm doing this so that the paint has something nice and smooth to lay down on. The cool part about self-etching primer is that once you lay it on pretty thick, it will smooth itself out. Now on to the back part of the case. All I'm doing is dusting it off and make sure there's no dirt laid down on it. Then I'm going to come in, and since I didn't sand it all the way down to the metal, I'm actually just going to use some adhesion promoter, because basically I'm painting on top of paint. If you go all the way down to the metal, you can just use primer. When I say lay it on thick, I do mean thick. Just use smooth strokes so you don't get any runs or drips, but it's okay to really lay this stuff on. When you lay it on thick, give it plenty of time to dry, and you'll be surprised. It will level out pretty much on its own. Okay, I've got a thick layer of primer on both my front panel, which was plastic, and on my back panel, which is all metal. So now we've got a great base to put paint on top of. You could actually start right now, but one thing I want to do is I'm going to smooth it out. Now, when I smooth it out, I'm going to use 600 grit automotive sandpaper. And what I'm doing is I'm laying the groundwork for a smooth finish later on. The smoother you keep paint in between coats, the better it is later on, and the much easier it is to buff out the clear coat to make it really look professional. So I'm setting that good groundwork by smoothing out my base right now. All right. I'm going in now with my 600 grit sandpaper and just cutting down the high spots. I'm just getting it nice and smooth for my next step. What's my next step? You guessed it, base color. So I'm going in with my Dupli-Color black, and I'm just laying it in nice and light. Remember, smooth strokes and even coats. Now, what you're seeing me do is lay down the first coat. I will actually come back and lay in about two or three more coats to make sure that my base color is nice and thick.
Laying down a couple of layers of paint for your base color is not that hard, but now's when we need to get a little bit more detail about what comes next. That is making sure that each layer of paint is smooth and ready for the next layer. How do we do it? We do it by sanding. So we need to get into a little bit more detail when it comes to sanding. Sanding is one of the most confusing parts of the custom paint job. Now, the only thing you need to remember at this level is that there's only two types of sanding. There's regular sanding and then there's wet sanding. The reason you use wet sanding is when you start getting up into the higher grits of sandpaper, the dust that you produce while you're sanding actually clogs up your sandpaper. And the best way to avoid it is to keep your surface wet. Obviously, you have to use automotive sandpaper because it's designed to get wet. Now, we talked about when you sand between coats of paint. You can sand your base color, and you can actually usually get away with sanding it with 1000 grit and doing it dry. Since you're just very lightly sanding it just to get it smooth, generally you don't have to wet sand, but you can if you need to. The big point, Don't sand all the way through your color. You're just smoothing out the surface. Now, once you get into your design, you can't sand because you'll end up scratching your design. So that's why it's good to start off with a very smooth surface going into the design phase.
Now, between the coats of my base color, I sanded very, very briefly with 1000 grit. Now I'm just laying in one final layer of base color and I'm ready to go into my design. For my design, I'm gonna do some airbrush flames. Now, I'm not gonna go into the details of how I paint flames. I've got 100 other videos out there showing how to paint flames. And it's a little bit beyond the scope of this video. The only thing you really need to know is I laid down basically white and then I put a color coat on top of it of green to make it really shine through. The result I get is a really, really bright green flame. This is pretty much all I'm going to do on this case for the design phase. Obviously, the flames came out pretty cool.
Okay, I do want to show you one more trick during the design phase. Now, depending on what you're doing for your design, paint can always build up, but I told you, you've got to keep it thin so the clear coat goes on nice and smooth. There is one trick. One of the tricks is you can scratch down a little of the overspray. It doesn't matter whether you're airbrushing or using stencils or whatever you're doing. You can scratch down a little bit of that overspray, a little bit of that textured roughness without screwing up your design. The best way to do it is use some of these scouring pads. They're called automotive paint and body scuff pads, and usually made by 3M. Now, you can find these in auto stores and things like that, but hey, it's the same stuff on the back of your kitchen sponges, all right? So you can use those if you're having a hard time finding the ones that are actually designed for this. But it's pretty cool. All you do is you take it out, and then you go over your design very lightly, and it gets rid of some of the overspray without screwing up your design. So, pretty cool trick to keep those layers of paint in your design phase pretty thin.
So we've got our design done. We've got a great base color and a pretty cool design on top. All there left is to do now is clear coat and then finish. Hang on, part 3 is coming. I'm going to show you how to lay down some clear and start finishing your project. We'll be right back.